It's Friday, you guys. So it's the sweet life of Marykay with my brother Ricardo. We're at Golden Corral. We're going to a concert tonight. As I said before we got cut off, we're at Golden Corral. Say hey, Bakari.
What's up? What are you doing?
We're going to a concert tonight. The Wilds group is going to be in Greenville, North Carolina. So we in there like swimwear. Food good?
Yes.
Hey, turn out here. Put it on me. Hey, guys. So what's my weekend looking like? Tomorrow I'm going to like this. What did you call it, Bakari?
A seminar
on your work. And I'm going to a single session in my church. And I work on Sundays. That's pretty much what my weekend's looking like. But I work a short shift. Can't never talk. I work a short shift on Sunday. But welcome to the sweet life of Marykay.
I think back to a time that I was 8. I became a victim because mama worked late. Yeah, mama boyfriend had a demon called rape. He played her superhero, but when she left, took off his cape, see? But God was already working on my escape. He said he'll never give me more than I could take. As I became older, I kind of understood faith. I began to pray, and he began to save my child. Beware wolves in sheep's clothing. Your innocence was stolen, but you must forgive because you were chosen. To be a fisher or a man, one of my soldiers. Come follow me and I'll show you. But that I couldn't see even with my eyes open. So I headed to the streets with my thoughts unfocused. 16 on my own, I was homeless and hopeless. I went from praying to saying, yeah, I know what a dope is. At least that's what her flesh told her. See, I was chasing after money, but I didn't know what the goal was. Roaming in the world so cold, saying this was the hand I was dealt, so I gambled my soul. But man, I thank God for my Savior. Thank Him for His grace, and I thank Him for His favor. Because it was Him who kept me in spite of my behavior. Your destiny doesn't start till you decide who's greater. And that's Christ. So you gotta know that no weapon formed against you shall prosper. In spite of it all.
Cause y'all got the victory.
Thank you. concert is over.
Okay.
Yep, you got it. Nope, you're fine. Concert over. It's late. What time is it, y'all? Is it on me?
It's on your neck.
Here. Help it. Don't be that. Don't be that. What time is it?
Time for you to shut the...
It's late, y'all. It's like 2 o'clock in the morning. The concert was really good. I enjoyed
it. The hype man that seems like a year.
Hey, beautiful people, happy Saturday. So last night was amazing. I enjoyed the concert so much. I got home really late, so I slept in. First things first is headed to get these eyebrows snatched, because look, they ain't been snatched in forever and they need to be snatched. And I don't know what that did. I made a noise, so I might have made it blurry. But then I'm headed to like a seminar at the library. A good friend of mine is doing something for her senior graduation project, so I'll be doing that. And then I'll be going with the flow for the rest of the day. Like I said, I got a singles event tonight at my church, so we'll see, you know, what my day is going to bring from there. Hope you guys had an awesome Saturday, and I hope, you know, you're enjoying this day, whatever it is that you're watching. Comment, tell me what you did. Comment below, of course, interact, and I'll see you soon.
But during my 8th grade year at Rosewood Middle School, I struggled with depression. And I even had suicidal thoughts at one point. So my purpose for being here is helping someone that may be dealing with the same thing, and to go ahead and target that right now before it's too late. So again, I'm here to tell everyone, you are enough. And I'm not just saying that, you really are. And I hope everyone is encouraged throughout this seminar. So what is self-esteem? To understand what self-esteem truly is, one must first come to the realization of what it is not, and that is self-respect. Self-respect and self-esteem are two totally different things. A person with self-respect is one who simply likes him or herself. This self-respect is not contingent upon success, because there are always failures to contend to. Neither is it a result of comparing oneself with others, because there's always someone better. Those are usually categorized as self-esteem. Self-respect, on the other hand, is something that is perpetual. It's one thing or another. It's not a mixture of both. You either fully believe in yourself or you don't believe in yourself at all. Don't ever give up. There's someone out there that hasn't given up because of you. You are not alone in this, and you matter. I wrote this one. It was important to me because there really is someone out there that has been watching you, and you don't even know the lives that you've touched. Someone might have seen you get through something, and they're like, I can make it now. And they did not give up because of you. So if you think about the people that were about to give up, but they saw you and saw the way you lived and how you were confident in yourself, they did not give up. So you could have saved someone's life.
If you look inside your heart, you don't have to be afraid of what you are. And there's an answer when you reach into your soul, and the sorrow that you know will melt away. And then here will come.
striving to become single, still striving to become a unique, unbroken, whole individual. Again, marriage, listen to this, has a way of highlighting how unsingle we really are. It has a way of highlighting how unsingle we really are. Dating also has a way, because you can be single and be dating, but dating also has a way, because you can start dating folk and you can get involved with people and you can see, boom, I'm not single and neither are you. Mm-hmm. You know, we two sick people who got together and now we got a hot mix. Okay? So it is possible again to, and marriage again has a way of highlighting how unsingle we are, just at the same way that dating has a way. So listen at this. You do not need to marry someone until you are truly a single person. You should not be seeking to marry. And I wouldn't even go as far to say you really shouldn't be trying to date anyone until you're healthy. Mm-hmm. Until you have worked on you.
That's
because
good.
There's some people who have jumped out of one relationship into another, out of one marriage into another, and they haven't even fixed the problem that caused the issue of the divorce or the separation from whoever the boyfriend there was dated. They go from one relationship into another without stopping and saying, okay, wait a minute. Am I whole? Am I unique? Am I separate? Can I exist by myself in a whole, complete, unique, separate state and just be well with who I am? Or do I always need somebody in my life to feel like I'm okay? You know? So this is so important, and I thought this was ultimate. Before we move on to before I turn it over to my husband, write this in your notes. The ultimate goal and purpose, again, for every, especially Christian, every born-again believer, is to become single. That should be our goal, is to become single, okay? And this is, again, the ultimate goal and purpose for the singles clinic. Every time you come in here, this is our objective, is to help you become whole, to help you become separate, to help you find your uniqueness, to help you find your true identity in God through Jesus Christ, so that if you so choose to have a marital relationship, you are one whole waiting on another whole. You're not a half waiting on another half to become a whole. You're two wholes, and the two wholes shall become one whole. Isn't that a phenomenal mystery? How can two wholes become one whole? So it's just a mystery of God. So my question to you singles, after all of this, is what is wrong with being this that I just said? What is wrong with being single?
With that, because separate is powerful, because I don't need Catherine and neither does Catherine need me. We want each other. Yes. We're confident and comfortable with the fact that we can exist. We have our own mind. We can do and live and be who we even should be and supposed to be without each other. Now that sounds crazy, but two people who love each other like we do, but that's what makes our marriage healthy, is because she don't need me. And whenever you are needy or you need a situation, you become very vulnerable.
Yes.
Because that's when Bubba seeks those people out.
Yes.
The person who really is needy, because a needy person is the easiest person to control. Because if you find out what that person needs, you basically now can begin to develop a stronghold over that person with that particular need. What you have to know is I'm single. I have not only a relationship with God, but I'm a human being who has my own mind and the ability to create within myself what I need. And that means I can even deal with life circumstances. Some people I've heard, and I say this respectfully, that I've heard some singles say, well, you know what, I just can't live single anymore. I need to have a mate because I can't take these bills. I can't keep dealing with these children alone. And what that is saying is, even if you found a mate, you're not ready for me because you can't handle life alone.
That's good.
And you feel like if I get somebody else, I'll be able to handle it. But what you may not realize is that when that person comes, they're going to bring a whole new dynamic of issues. And you couldn't even handle your own issues. And now you got to deal with yours still and theirs. And I'm telling you, sometimes those combined are very, very convulsive. It could become disastrous.
Hey, you guys, it's Saturday night, so I'm coming to say goodnight to you all. I thoroughly enjoyed my day. Friday and Saturday has been a great day. That it makes sense. I can never talk. Friday and Saturday have been great days. I've enjoyed and it's been fun. I am not stopping to re-record. The singles session tonight at the singles clinic was great. I enjoyed it. Tomorrow we have church and then I work right after church. Well, a couple hours after church. And then I come home and I'm going to prepare for my week. Next Friday, I will be ministering in a city near where I live. So that's going to be great. Hopefully some footage will be taken from that service. And I hope that you have had a great weekend so far. One more day and then we're going to wrap it up. Hey y'all, it's Sunday afternoon. I could not record this morning on the way to church. It got busy. I woke up late. I overslept. You ever have those mornings? Feel like your life is not together. But I've ate. I'm about to head to work. Actually, I work 3 to 8. Not so bad. I'm ready to go. I'm ready to get it over with. And then I'm gonna come home and get ready for the week. I got schoolwork to do. I have so much to do. I'm speaking on Friday, so I have to prepare for that. Then it's my birthday. So, a lot going on this upcoming week, but it's worth it. So, I'll come back and I'll say goodnight. I don't know if I'm going to record while I'm at work or, I mean, you know, like I usually do. So, I'll probably just come back and say goodnight. And if, I don't know. I hope that you guys have had a wonderful Sunday, a wonderful weekend. Please tell me what you did. Interact, comment below. Let me know. And I'll be looking forward to next week. Remember, my birthday is coming up October 25th. This is Sunday right now, so 7 days away. I'll upload on Friday, so it will be 2 days away from when I upload this video. So I'm excited. I'm excited about a new season in my life and new age and all this good stuff. So, have a great day. Hey, you guys. It's Sunday night. Coming to say goodnight. Work was cool. Went by fast. Got to work tomorrow. So, I'm going to shut it down. I hope you guys had a fantastic weekend. And until next weekend, I love you guys. Good night.